So we'll see what is the definition of inverse Laplace transforms, right? So this is the second lecture of network analysis using Laplace transformations. So let's see how to find a inverse Laplace transform. So definitions to find out inverse Laplace transform of any function f of s, right, from the frequency domain to the time domains. So definition, so we have to integrate this minus sigma minus j infinite to the sigma plus j infinite the function f of s with the multiplication with e raised to st into dt. So this is the definitions how to find the inverse Laplace transforms from a f of s, how to convert into the f of t. In most of practice, the inverse Laplace transform is fine using some Laplace transform of the basic signals. So we arrange the f of s in such a way that it is a Laplace transform of some of the basic signals or the basic signal with the multiplication with exponential signals if I have the delay, right? So Laplace transform normally find by using the partial fraction expansion of f of s and arrange each terms such a way that it is a Laplace transform of some of the basic signals. Now next topic we will see some theorems, basic theorems of Laplace transforms. Basic theorems of Laplace transform. Laplace transformation. Great. So first theorem, let's see the linearity or rather linear combination of the two signals. So it is called a linearity. So Laplace transforms, it is a linear functions. So if any signal A into F1 of t into B into F2 of t, Laplace transform of this signal, it is integrations of 0 to infinite the signal A F of t plus B F2 of t. So A F1 of t plus B F2 of t multiply by e raised to minus st dt, right? So we can apply this e raised to minus st into both the functions as well as the integration to both the functions dt plus 0 to infinite b f of 2 e raised to minus st dt, right? So this function is nothing but the a is constant, so we can take outside. F2 of t e raised to minus st dt. Great. So this is nothing but the Laplace transform of f1 of s. So it can write as f1 of s, and this is nothing but the Laplace transform of f2 of s. So it is b f2 of s, right? So the Laplace transform of any signal a f1 of t plus b f2 of t, the linear combination of two signals, it's lap in a s domain also, it is a linear combination of these two signals. It's Laplace transform linear combinations. right? Suppose we call this is the new signal, new third signal f3 of t, which is the linear combination of a f1 of t plus b f2 of t, and we know the Laplace transform of f1 of t and the Laplace transform of f2 of t. We can directly find the Laplace transform of f3 of t, which is a linear combination of a f1 of t plus b f2 of t. So we have to apply the same linear combination in Laplace transform. So f3 of s, it is a f1 of s plus b f2 of s. So Laplace transformation, it is a linear functions. So we can apply the linearity theorems. It's applicable in a Laplace domains. So whatever the addition and subtraction or the any form in a time domain, same that have to be applied in a frequency domain, in S domain. So this is the linearity theorems. Now next theorem is the integrations. So how to find the Laplace transform of a integrations. So next theorem is the transform of integrations. Transforms of integration. Derivative. Let's first find the transform of derivative. Derivative terms. Derivatives. Right. So here we want to find out the transform of derivative of f of t. We know the transform of f of t. So if we derivate any signal in a time domain, what should be the change in its frequency domain, that we want to find out. So here we want to find out the Laplace transform of this derivative terms d divided by dt f of t. We want to find out Laplace transform of this. So it can find at 0 to infinite, and d upon dt f of t into e raised to minus st dt. Right. So this is derivative term. It is our function into e raised to minus st into dt 0 to integration 0 to infinite. It is the Laplace transform of the derivative terms. Let's take in this u is equal to e raised to minus st, and dv is equal to df of t. So from this we can say du, derivative of this e raised to minus st, it is minus s e raised to minus st, and integration of the both the side from this to find out the v. So we can write as a f of t, integrate both the sides, so differential term is cancelled, so v is equal to f of t. So now we know integration of 0 to infinite of two function. One is the u into dv. It can write the uv 0 to infinite minus 0 to infinite integration of v into du. So for the integration, we know integration of two terms which are two variable, u into dv. Its integration can write its uv 0 to infinite minus 0 to infinite v into du, right? So let's substitute this value. So the Laplace transform of derivative terms d upon dt of f of t is equal to, let's substitute the value u and v. So what is the value of this? Is nothing but the u is nothing but the e raised to minus st, right? And dv, it is nothing but the df of t, this derivative of f of t. So u into dv, that is the d upon dt f of t into e raised to minus st. So this term is as it is. Now u is equal to minus s e raised to minus st into v, and v is equal to f of t, and this limit is 0 to infinite minus v du is equal to minus s e raised to minus st. Sorry, here u is equal to e raised to minus st, and dv is equal to df t, right? 0 to infinite minus v into df t, and du is equal to v is equal to f of t. So e raised to minus st u is equal to e raised to minus st and v is equal to f of t. So e raised to minus st, e raised to minus st into v, v is equal to f of t, and it is 0 to infinite minus 0 to infinite v, v is equal to f of t and du, and du is equal to e raised to minus e raised to s minus s e raised to minus st, right? E raised to minus st. Into dt. So first term, if we substitute this value e raised to minus infinite, so here it is e raised to minus infinite f of t, f of infinite, and let you substitute the zero, so minus e raised to zero f of zero plus or f of 0 minus minus plus s 0 to infinite f of t into e raised to minus st dt. So this terms it nothing but the f of 0 minus f of 0 or f of 0 plus, and this term is s, and this term is nothing but the f of s. This is the Laplace transform of f of s, right? So we can say the Laplace transform of derivative terms, Laplace transform of derivative terms d upon dt f of t is equal to s f of s minus f 0 plus minus its initial conditions. So Laplace transform of derivative term is, we have to multiply the Laplace transform of f of t with s minus its initial conditions. It is the Laplace transform of a derivative terms. Now suppose it's d square, 2 times of derivatives. So if you want to find out the Laplace transform of d square dt square f of t, right? So it can write as Laplace transform of d upon dt of d upon dt of f of t, right? So we know the Laplace transform of d upon dt of f of t. So we have to take its again derivatives, right? So it is, we know the Laplace transform of this derivative terms, it is s into the Laplace transform of d upon dt of f of t, right? Then minus minus d upon dt of f of 0 plus, right? So what is the Laplace transform of these terms? It is s, Laplace transform of these terms is, we already derived s into f of s minus f 0 plus minus f 0 plus, right? So Laplace transform of second derivative is s square f of s minus s f 0 plus minus the derivative terms of its second initial conditions. So this is the Laplace transform of second order differential term, Laplace transform of a second order differential terms. So in generalized nth order differential terms, Laplace transform is s raised to n f of s minus s raised to n minus 1 f of 0 plus minus s raised to n minus 2 d upon dt of f of 0 plus up to the minus s raised to n minus 1 s raised to 0 s raised to 0 is 1, so it is d raised to n minus 1 upon dt raised to n minus 1 f of 0 plus. So this is Laplace transform of a generalized nth order derivative terms. Let me similarly find the Laplace transform of a integral term. Laplace transform of a integral. So here we want to find out Laplace transform of a integration 0 to t f of t dt. What is Laplace transform of these terms? So we know the definition of Laplace transform. It is the we have to integrate the function 0 to infinite. So here our function is the integration 0 to t f of t dt. This is our function. And it is multiply with e raised to minus st into dt. Now let take here u is equal to 0 to t f of t into dt, and dv is equal to e raised to minus st dt. So from this we can say du, derivative of this, so integration and derivation is cancelled, so it is then f of t dt, and integration of both the side, so here the integration is e raised to minus st divided by minus s, right? So the Laplace transform of a integral terms 0 to t f of t dt, it can define as u v 0 to infinites minus integrations of v into du. So u v we can say it is 0 to infinite 0 to t f of t into dt into v is equal to e raised to minus st divided by minus s. So limit is 0 to infinite minus v is equal to e raised to minus st divided by minus s, and du is equal to f of t into dt. So here minus minus plus, and let's substitute the limit. So here first the limit is infinite, so e raised to minus infinite is 0 minus the lower limit. So when we substitute the lower limit, then this integration is 0 to 0. So integration is 0 to 0, t is 0. So upper and lower limit is same in integration. So again the answer of integration is 0. So when we substitute the upper limits, at that time e raised to minus infinity is 0, and we substitute that a lower limit, at that time this t value is 0, so integration is 0 to 0 is 0. So this term's answer is 0. Minus minus plus, integrations of f of t into e raised to minus st dt, where integration is 0 to infinite. Now this into 1 upon s. Right. So this is nothing but the f of s divided by s, where this is nothing but the f of s. So Laplace transform of a integral term 0 to t f of t dt, it is f of s divided by s. Function f of s, which is the Laplace transform of f of t divided by s. Right. Now, if we want to find out the Laplace transform of which have the initial condition, means the Laplace transform of minus infinite to t, the function of Laplace transform of minus infinite to t, right? So this function is divided in two part. The Laplace transform of first function is 0 to minus infinite to 0 minus f of t dt, and another is Laplace transform of 0 plus 2t f of t dt after the switching, right? So this indicate nothing but the initial conditions. Initial conditions minus infinite to zero, initial charge or initial flux. Now suppose the f of t is a current, then this value, suppose the f of t, it is a current functions, I of t, it is a current, then integration of current is charge. So this term at that times minus infinite to zero minus f of t dt, it is some charge present before the switching. It can be represented as q of 0 minus, right? And suppose the f of t, if it is a voltage signal, then if you integrate the voltage, then integration of voltage, it will make the flux. So it is a initial flux present in a circuits, right? So flux can write is as an L into the I of 0 minus inductance into the current passing through it, which is decide the flux around the inductor. So when we do the integrations for minus infinite to t f of t dt, so it is integration. So this terms, first term, which is the initial conditions. So if it's in current, then it this it value, it is a q of 0 minus, and Laplace transform of q of 0 minus plus the Laplace transform of these terms, and we know the Laplace transform of these terms is f of s divided by s, right? So it is the initial current, then f of t, suppose it is an current, then here it is an I of s, the current value divided by s. Now Laplace transform of constant, it is a constant divided by s. So Laplace transform of constant is constant divided by s, so f of s divided by s, right? So Laplace transform of a any signals, integrations of any signal from minus infinite to zero, we have to add with the f of s, with the addition with its initial condition divided by s. Its initial condition divided by s. Now we'll find how to find the inverse Laplace transform. It is very much important. So to find out the inverse Laplace transforms, first of all we have to arrange the our function using the partial fraction expansion, simple terms that can be directly we can find its inverse Laplace transform from the basic signals. Am I audible? Yes. So next topic is our partial fraction expansions. You already studied. Then let again for these topics I want to repeat it. So partial fraction expansion. Partial fraction expansion of any terms. So if we applied the KVL or KCL to our any network, it form a differential equations, right? It will form a differential equations. And if you solve that differential equations using the Laplace transform, suppose it is form a differential equation like d raised to n a 0 a 1 d raised to n minus 1 I divide by dt raised to n minus 1 up to the a raised to n minus 1 d I divide by dt plus a n into I is equal to some function f v of t. It will form some KVL equation. It will form like the voltage is equal to some this form, right? Now, if we by taking the Laplace transform, if we take the Laplace transform of this derivative terms, it will be converted into the S domains, and we know that I of S. So here it is a zero raised to S raised to n I of S plus a one here S raised to n minus one I of S plus some initial conditions like that. Let me take an initial condition on n front end side. So here S I of S plus a n into I of S is equal to V of S plus the initial condition of these terms, because when we find the Laplace transform of any derivative terms, it is S F of S minus F0 plus. So whatever the initial conditions, so here we'll write the initial conditions. Initial conditions. So if you want to solve for the I of S, so I of S will form the V of S plus the initial conditions. Divide by S raised to n a zero S raised to n plus a one S raised to n minus one plus up to the a n, right? It will form such polynomial equations. So it can be generalized. It can be formed as some polynomial numerator polynomial divided by some denominator polynomial. So in a generalized, any function can be defined I of S. It's have some P of S divided by Q of S, where the P of S is the numerator polynomial in terms of S, and the Q of S is the denominator polynomial in terms of S. And if we equate the denominator polynomial is equal to zero, it is, and what are the that solution will get of S, it is called a root of, or this equation it is called an characteristics equation of characteristics equation. This is called a characteristics equations, and the solution means the root of this characteristics equation are the root of the functions Q of S, right? Now suppose when we applied the partial fraction expansion, before that we have to verified the order of numerator polynomial must be less than the order of denominator polynomial before applying the partial fraction expansion. The order of S of numerator polynomial must be less than the order of S of the denominator polynomial. If not dissatisfied, if the order of numerator, if it's greater than the order of denominator, then we'll get the P of S divided by Q of S is equal to, let me, if we divide the P of S divided by Q of S, it has some numerator. If the numerator have the higher order compared to the denominator, m minus n S raised to m minus n, where m is plus some P1 of S divided by Q of S, where m is order of numerator polynomial. And n is order of denominator polynomial. Right. So if the numerator have the higher order compared to the denominator, it's have the S raised to m minus n in a numerator plus some P1 of S divided by Q of S, then we have to do the partial fraction of these terms, P1 of S divided by Q of S. Suppose if n is greater than m, then directly we have to do the partial fraction of Q of S divided by p of s divided by q of s, right? So normally most of function have the denominator have the higher order compared to the numerator polynomial, and such function is always a stable. So it's our now let's do the partial fractions. Also it is called an Heaviside expansion theorems. Partial fraction another name is also called an Heaviside expansion theorem. Partial fraction is also called an Heaviside expansion theorem, right? So how to do the partial fraction if the numerator polynomial is less than the denominator polynomial? Then we have to first find the characteristics equation, which is q of s we have to equate to 0 and we have to factorize the q of s. So suppose q of s is a of 0 s raised to n, a 1 s raised to n minus 1 up to the a minus 1 into s plus a n. So it can be factorized into the a 0 s minus s 1 s minus s 2 up to the s minus s n have the n different that root. Now so generalize q of s it defined as a 0 product of j is equal to 1 to n s minus s j s minus s j, right? Where s1, s2 up to the sn are the n root of these characteristics equations. Now how to do the partial fraction expansion? So let's see the partial fraction expansion for three different cases. Case 1, in which the roots 0 to n, roots, if the roots are simple, real and simple, if roots of characteristics equation are real and simple. It is a real number, it not a complex. If the roots are the real, right, and the simple means it is some different values, it not a repetitive roots. So by equating the q of s is equal to 0, so any p of s divided by q of s it defined as a p of s divided by the roots of the q of s s minus s1 s minus s2 up to the s minus sn. So this can be equate to the k1 divided by s minus s1 plus another constant k2 divided by s minus s2 up to the kn divided by s minus sn. So we can be expand these functions p of s divided by s minus s1 into s minus s2 up to the s minus sn if the s1 not equal to s2 not equal to sn and it not equal to a complex number, it is real number, then it can be expand using the partial fraction expansion like k1 divided by s minus s1 plus k2 divided by s minus s2 plus k3 divided by up to the kn divided by s minus s1, where the k1, k2, kn coefficients can be find by multiplying the quotient of p1 of q1 by denominator of that coefficients. Suppose if you are finding the k1, then we have to multiply p of s divided by q of s with the denominator term of the k1, which is s minus s1, and equating s is equal to the s1, whatever the root of that coefficients denominator terms, right? So suppose if you want to find out a k1, then we have to multiply the p of s divided by q of s multiply by s minus s1, and we have to put the value of s is equal to s minus s1 is equal to 0. So value of s is equal to s1. So in this equation, equation we have to substitute the value of s is equal to s1, and whatever the answer, that is our k1, the coefficient value k1, right? So in a generalized, suppose if you want to find out the kj, any terms, any coefficients, so it can be find as we have to p of s divide by q of s multiplied with s minus sj, and we have to substitute the value of s is equal to sj, equating s minus sj is equal to 0. So whatever the value of s, that we have to substitute in equation to find out the coefficients value. So it is very simple. First case, for the partial fraction expansions, if the roots are real and simple. Now let take the second case. So in a second case, case 2, complex conjugate root, complex conjugate roots, if the roots are complex conjugate, means any p1 of s divided by q of s, where the characteristics equation have the two complex conjugate roots. So complex conjugate root is s minus alpha minus j beta, and another complex conjugate of this is s minus alpha plus j beta, right? And let's say remaining roots are some different roots q1 of s. So it can be write as k1 divided by s minus alpha minus j beta plus another roots for the root s minus alpha plus j beta, which is the complex conjugate of s minus alpha minus j beta. So coefficients is also a complex conjugate of the k1, so s minus alpha plus j beta, right? So these two are the complex conjugate root, so its coefficients is also a complex conjugate root plus as another terms, another constant as per the q1 roots, right? So if you want to find out k1, so k1 can find as p1 of s divided by q of s multiply with the denominator term of k1, which is s minus alpha minus j beta, and we have to substitute the value of s is equal to 0. So value of s is equal to alpha plus j beta, alpha plus j beta, and whatever the value of k1 will get, some value of k1. So not need to find out the k1 star, which is always a complex conjugate pair. So we have to take the k1 star, the complex conjugate of k1. So whatever the value of k1, take its complex conjugate, it is the another constant, the k1 star, in a case of 2, which is roots are complex conjugate roots. Now let's take the third case, which is sum of slightly difficult to find out a partial fraction expansion for the third case, which is when the roots are repetitive roots, repeated roots, roots are repeated roots. Repeated roots means, suppose p of s divided by q of s, it have some repetitive roots, r of s divided by s minus sj raised to r, different r repetitive roots. So it can write the k j1 s minus sj plus k j2 divided by s minus sj square up to the k j r, where s minus sj raised to r. Now to find out the coefficient in that case, so what is the r of s? So r of s can write, it is that p of s into q of s multiply by s minus sj raised to r, right? By multiplying this, we'll get the r of s. Now to find out the any coefficient kjn out of k KJ1 to KJR, if any intermediate coefficient n, if you want to find out in the case of when the roots are the repetitive roots. So the formula for that is 1 upon r minus n factorial. R is the total number of repetitive roots and n is the nth coefficients which we are finding, right? So that value of n is that coefficient value. So r minus 1 factorial, and derivative of r minus 1 times the derivative of term p of s divided by q of s into s raised to s j raised to r, and s is equal to s j. So what, how to find out the coefficient when the roots are the repetitive roots? So first of all, we have to multiply p of s divided by q of s multiply s minus s j raised to r, means the we have to multiply the maximum power of s. Then we have to do the derivative of that terms. How many, what is the order of derivative that decide the which coefficients we are finding? So maximum number of repetitive roots divided minus n, right? Nth, if you are finding nth coefficient. So d raised to r minus n divided by ds raised to r minus 1 multiply by 1 upon r minus 1 factorials, right? So this is the three different case of we have the polynomial equations of which we want to do the partial fraction expansion. So depending on the polynomial equations, we have to apply how to find its partial fraction expansion. So let's take the example to solve a different find the inverse Laplace transform of a different signals. So let me solve some example. Find inverse Laplace transform of following function. So our first function, let's take s minus 1 divided by s square plus 3s plus 2. Let our first case of which we want to find out is inverse Laplace transform. So this is our f of s. So f of s, here it is given s minus 1 divided by s square plus 3s plus 2. So how to find its inverse Laplace transform? If possible, let's do its partial fraction expansion. So before to do the partial fraction expansion, we have to see what is the order of the numerator polynomial and denominator polynomial. So here the order of numerator polynomial is 1 and the order of denominator polynomial is 2. So order of the denominator polynomial is greater than the order of numerator polynomial. So let's find the roots of the characteristics equation. So here the characteristics equation is s square plus 3s plus 2 is equal to 0, right? So how to factorize s square plus 3s plus 2? It can factorize 2 and 1, right? So it can find as s plus 2 and s plus 1 is equal to 0. So we can write the f of s is equal to s minus 1 divided by s plus 2 and s plus 1. So this is nothing but our p of s divided by q of s, where p of s is s minus 1 and q of s it is s plus 2 into s plus 1, right? So that can be factorized. So here the roots are simple. The roots are minus 2 and minus 1. So both the roots are simple, which is not a complex number, as well as both the roots are different. Here is one is minus 2 and another is minus 1. So both the roots are different. So procedure to do its partial fraction expansion is, we have to take as many roots, we have to find out that coefficient. So coefficient k1 and denominator of coefficient k1 is s plus 2, plus coefficient k2, denominator of coefficients k2 is s plus 1. Now how to find out the k1? So we know to find out the k1, k1 k1 is we have to multiply this function p of s divided by q of s. So p of s is s minus 1 and q of s is s plus 2 and s plus 1. We have to multiply this function with the denominator part of k1. So denominator part of k1 is s plus 2. So we have to multiply this function with s plus 2. And in this equation we have to substitute s is equal to, we have to equate s plus 2 is equal to 0, so s is equal to minus 2. So in this equation we have to substitute s is equal to minus 2. So s plus 2 cancel. So remaining part is s minus 1 divided by s plus 1. And in that we have to substitute s is equal to minus 2. So minus 2 minus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. Right, so minus 3 divided by minus 1, so k1 is equal to 3. So value of k1 is equal to 3. Similarly, let find the value of k2. So k2, so when we are finding k2, we have to multiply the this function s minus 1 divided by s plus 2 and s plus 1. This multiplied with s plus 1. And we have to substitute the value of s is equal to s minus 1. S is equal to minus 1. So let me this s plus 1 is cancelled and substitute s is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 minus 1 divided by s plus 2. S is equal to minus 1 plus 2. So minus 1 is minus 2 and divide by plus 1. So value of k2 is minus 2. So once we'll get the coefficients value, so we have to write the, our f of s, which is equal to s minus 1 divided by s plus 2 s plus 1. It can write the k1, which is value is 3 divided by s plus 2, and the k2, which is minus 2, which is so 2 divided by s plus 1 s plus 1. Now we know now we want to find out its inverse Laplace transforms. Now we want to find out the function f of s, which is equal to 3 divided by s plus 2 minus 2 divided by s plus 1. Right? Now we want to find out inverse Laplace transform of these functions. So we know the inverse Laplace transform of, we know what is the Laplace transform of e raised to minus at into u of t. So Laplace transform of this signal is, what is Laplace transform of this signal? It is 1 upon s plus a. Laplace transform of signal e raised to minus at, which we already find, it is 1 upon s plus a. So if we have signal 1 upon s plus a, so what is its inverse Laplace transforms? Inverse Laplace transform is e raised to minus at. E raised to minus at. So what is in our this case? So let's take the inverse Laplace transform. Taking the inverse Laplace transform, Laplace transform, so f of s, it is f of t. Inverse Laplace transform of f of s is f of t. Inverse Laplace transform of 3 divided by s plus 2, so it is 1 upon s plus 2. So 1 upon s plus 2 inverse Laplace transform is e raised to minus 2t. E raised to minus 2t. And minus 2, 1 upon s plus 1. We here a is equal to 1. So e raised to minus at. So e raised to minus t. So inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 2, it is e raised to minus 2t. And the inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 1, it is e raised to minus t. So inverse Laplace transform of complete function is 3 e raised to minus 2t minus 2 e raised to minus t. So this is our answer, the inverse Laplace transform of the function s minus 1 divided by s plus 2 into s plus 1. Right? Now let's take the one more example in which we need the partial fraction expansion of a complex signals. So our next example is, let me find the inverse Laplace transform of a another signal f of s is equal to 1 upon s square plus 4s plus 5. So here also the denominator have the higher order compared to the numerator. So do directly partial fraction expansions. So this can be write as how to write s square plus 4s plus 5. So this 5 can divide in two part, that we can have a 4 plus 1. So it can write s square plus 4s plus 4 plus 1, right? Now we can say j square is equal to now s square plus 4s plus 4, it can write s plus 2 no square, s plus 2 square, and plus 1 it can represent as minus j square. J square is minus 1, so minus minus plus, so this plus 1 it can represent minus j square. Now this is the form of let's s plus 2 is equal to a, so a square minus b square, so it is two factor, one is a plus b and another is a minus b. So first is s plus 2 plus j, and another factor is s plus 2 minus j, right? So f of s here have the two complex root, s plus 2 plus j into s plus 2 minus j. Both the root are complex conjugate, both the root are complex conjugate to each other. So first root is s1, it is equal to minus 2 minus j, another root s2, which is equal to minus 2 plus j. So minus 2 minus j nu apne complex conjugate, if we find the complex conjugate of minus 2 minus j, it is minus 2 plus j, real part as it is, and imaginary part you have to do the polarity change, so it is a complex conjugate pair. So here both the root are complex conjugate. So in such case, how to find its inverse Laplace transforms? So for the inverse Laplace transform, s divided by s plus 2 plus j and s plus 2 minus j, it can find its k1 divided by s plus 2 plus j and its complex conjugate divided by s plus 2 minus j, right? So k1 can find is equal to 1 upon this function s plus 2 plus j into s plus 2 minus j multiply by the denominator part of k1, which is s plus 2 plus j, and substitute the value of j is equal to s plus 2 plus j is equal to 0, so s is equal to minus 2 minus j. So this is cancel plus plus, and by substituting the value of s is equal to minus 2 minus j, so it is 1 upon minus 2 minus j plus 2 minus j. So minus 2 plus 2 is cancel, so k is equal to 1 upon minus 1 upon 2j, minus 1 upon 2j. So complex conjugate k1 star is equal to, so here will, so k is equal to minus 1 divided by 2j, so k1 star is equal to complex conjugate of these terms, so it is equal to 1 upon 2j plus 1 upon 2j, which is the complex conjugate of minus 1 upon 2j, right? Substitute this value, so f of s will get minus 1 upon 2j divided by s plus 2 plus j and plus 1 upon 2j divided by s plus 2 minus j, s plus 2 minus j, right? So let me take 1 upon 2j common, 1 upon 2j, so in bracket 1 upon s plus 2 minus j, and another term minus 1 upon s plus 2 plus j, right? Now we know the Laplace transform of e raised to minus at sine omega t, e raised to minus at sine omega t. Laplace transform of this term is, we have to shift the sine functions, we have to shift the sine functions. So let me first let me simplify it before doing its inverse Laplace transform. So 1 upon 2j, so here let me take the LCM, plus j माइनस माइनस टू प्लस जे डिवाइड बाय एस प्लस टू प्लस जे मल्टीप्लाई बाय एस प्लस टू माइनस जे. सो हियर वी कैन से वन अपन टू जे मल्टीप्लाई विथ एस एस कैंसल टू टू कैंसल. सो हियर इट इज इन टू जे डिवाइड बाय हियर इट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन दिस टर्म्स मल्टीप्लाई विथ दिस. सो हियर इट इज एन ए प्लस जे ए माइनस जे. सो इट कैन राइट द एस प्लस टू नो स्क्वेर माइनस जे स्क्वेर. सो माइनस जे स्क्वेर इज प्लस वन. सो इट कैन राइट टू जे कैंसल. सो इट कैन राइट वन अपन एस प्लस टू स्क्वेर प्लस वन एंड वन कैन राइट एज ए वन स्क्वेर राइट. सो हियर इट इज एन अवर एफ ऑफ एस. Now we know what is the Laplace transform of e raised to minus at sin omega t is. It is omega divided by s square s plus a square omega square. Right? Here it is shifted by a in a s domain. So if we multiplied any signal in time domain with the exponential signal e raised to minus at sin omega t, then in its Laplace transform it is shifted by a, right? So wherever the a, it is a s plus a. So now we have the signal which with us it is a 1 upon s plus 2 square plus 1 square. So what is the now what is the inverse Laplace transform of this? So here the omega is 2 and omega is 1 and a is equal to 2. So it can write e raised to minus a t. So e raised to minus 2 t and omega is equal to 1. So it is omega into t. So sine into t. So inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 2 raised to square plus 1 square. It is e raised to minus 2 t sine omega t. So if you compare these two, you will get the inverse Laplace transform of the these terms which we are derived. So by taking inverse Laplace transform f of t is equal to inverse Laplace transform of this term is e raised to minus 2t sine into t. E raised to minus 2t sine into t. So is it clear how to find the inverse Laplace transform using the partial fraction expansions? So we have to do the partial fraction expansion and convert in S domain in a form of our basic signal Laplace transforms. So we can directly do its Laplace transforms and convert into its basic, we can use that basic signal Laplace transform equations. Now let's take the third case in which we have the repetitive roots and how to find its Laplace transform. So our third signal, In that case the roots are repetitive roots. So in third signal is f of s is equal to 1 upon s s square plus 6s plus 9. Right? So how to factorize it? It is 1 upon s and factorize of s square plus 6s plus 9, it is s plus 3 no square. S plus 3 into s plus 3, so it is s plus 3 square. Right. So how to find its inverse Laplace transform? How to first do its factorizations? So in a factorization, 1 upon s plus 3 square, it factorizes k1 upon s plus 3 plus k2 divided by s plus 3 square. Plus third root is simple, which is s k3 divided by s. Right. So to find out the k3, which is very simple, this k3 denominator is not a repetitive roots. So it is simple method. We have to multiply it 1 upon s plus 3 no square. We have to multiply with s and we have to substitute s is equal to 0. So ss cancel. So 1 upon 3 square. Will get it is a 1 upon 9. So k3 is equal to 1 upon 9. Now let's find the value of k2. So in the find of value of k2, we have to multiply the p of s divided by q of s into. So here p of s divided by q of s is 1 upon s plus 3 no square, right? It multiply with s plus 3 square, and we have to substitute value of s is equal to minus 3. So if you cancel, so 1 upon minus 3. So it is minus 1 upon 3 k2. Now for the k1, we have to do it's 1 upon r minus 1 factorial, where r is 2 and here it is in first row. So 2 minus 1 factorial, derivative of r minus 1. So 2 minus 1 derivative of the term 1 upon s s plus 3 square multiplied by s plus 3 no square, right? So s plus 3 is cancelled. So it is derivative of 1 upon s, and derivative of 1 upon s is minus 1 upon s square, and 1 upon 1 factorial is 1. So here it is derivative of 1 upon s, and derivative of 1 upon s is minus 1 upon s square, and we have to substitute the value of s is equal to minus 3. So value of k1, it is equal to minus 1 divided by minus 3 square. So it is a minus 1 upon 9. So k1, it is minus 1 upon 9. Now let do its partial fraction expansion. So 1 upon s divided by s plus 3 square, it can represent as k3 divided by s. So it is in k3, it is equal to 1 upon 9 divided by s. Then k2 is a minus 1 upon 3 divided by s plus 3 no square, plus k1, which is a minus 1 upon 9. Minus 1 upon 9 divided by k1, which is 1 upon s plus 3. Now we know what is the, by taking the inverse Laplace transform, taking inverse Laplace transforms. Now inverse Laplace transform of any constant divided by s, it is a constant. So inverse Laplace transform first term is this 1 upon 9. Inverse Laplace transform of the second terms, so second term is 1 upon s plus 3 no square. Now we know the Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 3, Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 3, inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 3, it is e raised to minus 3t. Now if we square off that terms, then its inverse Laplace transform we have to multiply t with its time domain, because the Laplace transform of t is a 1 upon s square. So if you multiply the t with e raised to minus a t, then in a frequency domain it is shifted. So it is 1 upon s plus 3 no square, right? So inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 3 no square, it is a t into e raised to minus 3t. And the inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus 3, we know very well, it is e raised to minus 3t. E raised to minus 3t. So the inverse Laplace transform of whole signal, it is 1 upon 9 minus 1 upon 3 into t e raised to minus 3t minus 1 upon 9 e raised to minus 3t. So it is the inverse Laplace transform of a given signals. Now suppose also it can be asked, also it given differential equation, and say find out, solve this differential equations, find out the using the Laplace transformation method. Solve differential equation using Laplace transformations. So here the differential equation is d square I of t divided by dt square plus 4 di of t divided by dt plus phi into I of t is equal to phi u of t, where initial condition are given I of 0 plus is 1 and di of 0 plus divided by dt is equal to 2. So here we have to solve this differential equation and we have to find out the I of t, and we have to solve this differential equation using the Laplace transformation method. Laplace transformation methods. So we know the Laplace transform of derivatives. So how to find the, how to equate the Laplace transform of d square I of t divided by dt square. So Laplace, by taking the Laplace transform, so derivative Laplace transform, this is second order derivative. So it is a Laplace transform of this term is s square I of s minus s its first initial conditions minus its derivative of initial conditions. So this is Laplace transform of a d square I of t divided by dt square. Now Laplace transform of a first order derivative, it is s I of s minus its one initial condition, which is I0 plus, plus I of t, Laplace transform of I of t is I of s, so plus phi I of s is equal to phi u of t, and Laplace transform of u of t is a 1 upon s, which is our first signal for which we have find the already Laplace transforms. So u of t Laplace transform is 1 upon s, so phi divided by s. Now in this equation, let's substitute the value of I of 0 plus is 1 and di 0 plus divided by dt is equal to 2, and let me find a solution let me prepare this equation of I of s, and then we'll do the partial fraction expansion, and at the end we'll take the inverse Laplace transform, so we'll get the solution of I of t. So let's substitute the value of, so here s square into I of s minus I0 plus, so it is 1 minus 1 into s, 1 into s minus di 0 plus divided by dt value is 2 plus 4 s into I of s minus 4 into 1 is 4 plus 5 I of s is equal to phi divided by s. So let's take the I of s common, so we'll get s square from this terms 4s and with the last term phi, and let me take the remaining term on the right hand side. So phi divided by s minus s in this side, it is plus s, minus 2 in this side plus 2, minus 6 minus 4 take in this side, it is plus 4. So I of s square plus 4s plus 5, it can write, let's take the LCM here, so it is an s square plus 6s plus 5 divide by this. So I of s is equal to s square plus 6 of s plus 5 divide by s square plus 4 of s plus 5, 4 of s divided by 5, right? So this can be more simply and divide by s, so here it is divide by s, so here it is s multiply by s square plus 4s plus 5, s square plus 4s plus 5. So this can have the roots s square plus 4s plus 5, this we already have the root or the complex conjugate root, so it can write as k1 divided by s plus k2 divided by s square plus 4s plus 5, can write s plus 2 no square plus minus j square, right? It can write minus j square, so it is can write as s plus 2 plus j, and another coefficient is complex conjugate of first, which is s plus 2 minus j, right? Now how to find the coefficient? So k1 it can be find as s square plus 6s plus 5 divided by s square plus 4s plus 5 multiply by s and substitute s is equal to 0. So s cancel. So by substituting s is equal to 0, from the numerator is 5, from the denominator is also 5, so k is equal to 1. Now to find out the k2, so k2 can find as s square plus 6s plus 5 divided by s plus 2 plus j and s plus 2 minus j multiplied by s plus 2 plus j and substitute s is equal to minus 2 minus j, right? So here s plus 2 plus j, s plus 2 plus j is cancelled, and for the remaining terms substitute s is equal to minus 2 minus j. So minus 2 minus j square plus 6 minus 2 minus j plus 5 divided by minus 2 minus j minus 2 minus j plus 2 minus j, right? Simplified it will get the value of k2, it is equal to a j1. We'll get the value of k2 is equal to a j1. So k2 star, it is equal to minus j. K2 star is equal to its complex conjugate of this, so it is a minus j. Substitute this value of k1, k2 and the k2 star, so we'll get the I of s, it is equal to k1 is equal to 1, so 1 upon s plus k2 is equal to minus j divided by s plus 2 plus j, and k3 is equal to plus j divided by s plus 2 minus j, right? So this is the 1 upon s plus this terms. So let we take 1 upon s plus, let take the minus j common, plus j common, so in bracket 1 upon s plus 2 minus j and minus 1 upon s plus 2 plus j. Let take the LCM, so 1 upon s plus j, let take the LCM, so s plus 2 plus j minus s minus 2 plus j. So here it is cancelled, s and divide by s plus 2 plus j and s plus 2 minus j. So if you simplify it, we'll get 1 upon s and j, here it is in its value is 2j, so it is 2j square divide by s plus 2 no square plus 1 no square. So 2j square, it is a minus 1, so 1 upon s plus 2 minus, let take the minus common, and in bracket s plus 2 no square plus 1 square. So inverse Laplace transform of, taking inverse Laplace transform, so we'll get the solution of I of t. So I of t, inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s is u of t, and inverse Laplace transform of this term 1 upon s plus 2 square plus 1 square, where the 2 is the a, so e raised to minus 2t, and 1 is the omega, so it is sin t. So solution of this equation is this one.
You hello, sir.
Yes, yes.
So sir, we have lecture at 3:45.
Yes, yes. So we are coming to end. So solution of this equation, if we take the u of t is 1 for t greater than equal to 0. So if we take the t greater than equal to 0, so I of t. So we can solve differential equation using this Laplace transformation methods, right? So for what we have to do, we have to put the differential terms in the Laplace forms, and then we have to take the function I of s common, and we have to prepare the I of s in terms of s. Then doing the inverse Laplace, doing the partial fraction expansion, and then do the inverse Laplace transform of each basic signal, will get the Laplace transform of each partial fraction expansion terms into the basic signals. So it will make the easy to do its inverse Laplace transformations. Hope it is clear to all of you.